guys, my name is Trin and today I'm here to film a bookshelf tour. It's been at least a year and a half, I think, since I filmed a bookshelf tour, and of course I'll link like the two bookshelf tours that I have done in the past, so you know, all of the links will be down in the description box below. The reason why I really want to do one right now is because I'm very happy with like how I organize my books, and also shout out to my boyfriend because last week he helped me clean my bookshelves, and I mean like clean everything, like taking off the books and just wiping things down because it was so gross and dusty. So shout out to him. I really appreciate your help, Jonathan. I love you very much. Before we get into the video, I do want to say that this video has been sponsored by Ana Luisa. If you don't know, Ana Luisa is a sustainable jewelry company that is based in New York. Their pieces are long-lasting, crafted with care from the best noble metals with a 365-day warranty. Their prices are very fair, starting at $39, ranging to higher-end pieces. And also, I love the fact that Ana Luisa really cares about the environment. 100% of the carbon emissions related to the product's life cycle are offset, which ensure the highest production standards while eliminating excessive waste. As you can see, I am wearing their pieces right now. I'm wearing their newest ring. I believe this is called Wiley. First of all, I love the look of it. I think it's so simple yet pretty. And now this necklace set, I am in love with these necklaces. They look so beautiful. This comes in three, and of course I think this is called the Michelle necklace, and it matches with, you know, the Michelle earrings, and I'm just in love with this look. I think it's just so pretty. Another piece that they gave me is the Hannah necklace, and of course this is created by Hannah from A Clockwork Reader, who is a fellow booktuber. I am in love with all of these pieces. And of course, luckily for you, there is a sale going on right now. Everything on the website is 20% off, which is a really great deal. So I have my link down in the description box below for you to check it out. And I highly recommend the jewelry pieces. I am in love with all of them. And of course, I have like quite a lot now, and I'm just so happy to have them in my collection because I know for a fact I can wear them every single day for the next few years of my life, okay? I cannot wait to get a few more for myself and also for my family members as well, you know, because the holiday season is coming up. So yeah, thank you so much to Ana Luisa for sponsoring this video, and now let's get right into the bookshelf tour. First and foremost, I do want to give you like an overview of all of the bookshelves that I have in my room. The very first one, I've had this for a very long time, I think since high school, and basically it used to be brown and I painted it white like years ago, and now this is just the way it looks. And now to my right, as you can see, these bookshelves are from IKEA, I believe. So one has six shelves and then one has three shelves. And now the very last bookshelf, this one is from Target. Originally it has like four organizers, but since I got so many manga and comic books and graphic novels, I decided to just turn this into a bookshelf full of manga and comic books. You get it, okay? So that's basically the fourth shelf. Oh my god, I have four shelves. Wow, okay. So let's start with this one right here. I really hope the lighting is good. I'm trying my best right now. It's like late at night. But real quick, I do want to mention that when it comes to these leaves right here, I got these vines on Amazon, and basically I just used tape to tape everything to my bookshelf. So yeah, it's been looking really nice, and I love the way it looks, you know, it's just so pretty. So I'm in love with this. The very first shelf, I would call this my contemporary shelf because all of the books here are like, you know, mostly contemporary books. So of course we have like the romance books and, you know, the YA contemporaries. I will go through each shelf so you can see everything. So first let's start with the very top one. Up here I have my Doraemon manga. So those are like childhood books, you know. This right here, this is fake. Basically the flower is Hoa Mai, which is a popular flower in Vietnam during Tet. So I got this I think a few months ago, and I love it so much even though it's fake. And now the very first bookshelf. I am so short, I have to stand on my tippy toes right now. These two shelves right here, they're basically my adult romance novel shelves because I've been getting into romance novels again because I've always read them, you know, I loved them when I was in high school, but then I kind of fell out of love with them. But now I'm reading so many good adult romance novels, so of course I'm trying to expand these shelves. Let's start with the very top one. So here I have the the Brown Sisters trilogy. So Get a Life, Chloe Brown, Take a Hint, Danny Brown, and then After Age, Eve Brown. And then what's really cool is that I actually have an arc of Get a Life, Chloe Brown right here. And also real quick, there are so many like warnings, not warnings, but you get it. I am so short. For a while, I actually have a shelf for my ARCs, so that's like advanced reading copies, but since I unhauled like a good chunk of them, like I want to say a few weeks ago, I feel the need to not have a shelf dedicated to my ARCs because I honestly don't have a lot. So I just put them in their, in their genre. So here I have, you know, this book. This is an adult romance novel, so it's just going to be chilling here. next to the final copy. So as you can see, this is what it looks like, and I have a few arcs. So Happy Endings by Teen Kim Lam is also an arc right here. The Love Hypothesis, I want to read this book next because I've heard amazing things about this book, and I have an arc which is really nice, so I'm planning to read this next. I don't know what this trilogy is called, but basically the author is Helen Huang. So the first book is The Kiss Quotient, which is my least favorite book of the trilogy right now, and of course the next one is The Bride Test, which is one of my favorite books of 2020, which is a big deal. And then of course the newest book is The Heart Principle right here. So I just got this recently and I cannot wait to read it. Another arc is The Donut Trap by Julie Tew. I cannot wait to read this one. And then of course we have You Deserve Each Other, and then Twice Shy by Sarah Hogle. Oh my goodness, those books are so cute. So they're, you know, really wonderful. And then here I have Honey Girl, Red, White, and Royal Blue. And then One Last Stop. I'm actually reading One Last Stop right now. I have this on my shelf because I want it to look complete, you know, but after this video is done being filmed, I will take this off and finish the book, obviously. And then of course I got these books recently, Beach Read, and then also People We Met on Vacation by Hamlin Henry. I got this at Target 3 days ago, so you know, they're chilling my shelves right now. And then I actually just finished this book yesterday. Oh my goodness, The Spanish Love Deception. I got the physical copy for Aaron Blackford. What a man. Oh my god, what a man. Wow, this book is actually really fun and entertaining. And then this cup, I got this from Fairy Loot. So as you can see, this is what it looks like, and I use it for my bookmarks right here. And then last but not least, I have a painting of Happiny because it is one of my favorite Pokemon. So I put it right here because I have a space on the very first shelf. And now the second shelf right here. So real quick, I have the Pokemon cards that my boyfriend gave me. So these are the starter Pokemon for Hoenn, which is my favorite region ever. So of course, look at Torchic being so cute. And then Mudkip, as you can see, Mudkip. And then Treecko. The second shelf is of course another adult romance novel kind of shelf. Oh, as you can see, I have lots of books from Christina Loren because I have always loved their books since I was in high school. Okay, like I read these books when I was like a junior in high school, so it's been a long time. But as you can see, I have read a lot of their books, and I actually unhauled two recently. I think I unhauled Dating You, Hating You, something like that, and then also Roomies. I really, really don't care about those two books, so I decided to just unhaul them. And you know, I was like going back and forth because I'm like, okay, I have all of their books. However, I'm just like, don't keep the books that you don't care about. So I unhauled two books from them. So these are all of the books that I read and really enjoy. And now we have some more, what you call it, adult romance novels. So I have On Dublin Street by Samantha Young. I read this a long ass time ago again. And then here I have Easy and Breakable. I think these two books are mostly new adult. So you know, the two main characters, they're in college, I believe. So I put them here because they didn't really fit with like the YA books. So I just put them up here. And then we have Mad Romeo and Broken Juliet. There is a third book. I don't remember the title, Wicked something. I don't even remember. I remember not liking the third book at all. And honestly, it's just irrelevant in the trilogy. So I unhauled the third book and I have the first two books. And then recently I read The Wall of Winnipeg and Me by Mariana Zapata. The audiobook is so, so good. So the moment I finished the book, I purchased a copy for myself right here. And do you see how big this is? This is just a regular adult romance novel, and the size of it reminds me of like a fantasy book, which is a pretty big deal. Like there are 650 pages. Of this book right here. So it's really, really big, but man, it was a good time. Okay, that book was a good time. Unfortunately, I am on my knees right now. So the third shelf that I have on this bookshelf right here, this is my LGBTQIAP+ bookshelves. I think all of the books right here, they're mostly YA contemporary books. So of course I used to have Red, White, and Royal Blue, and then also One Last Stop, and then also Honey Girl on here. However, those books are like towards adults, you know, they're a little bit more explicit. So I put them on the very first shelf. So this one has all of the YA books, you know, that are dealing with like the LGBTQIAP+ community. You get it. I'm a mess right now. I tried to color coordinate them. As you can see, I have like red, yellow, orange, and then blue, purple. I have no green, surprisingly. I wanna say my favorite, one of my favorite books, okay? Felix Ever After by Kaysen calendar. Look at this beautiful cover. I am obsessed with this book. I cannot wait to reread this book sometime in the future because I would love to, you know, read it again and annotate the book, because the first time I read the book was, you know, through audiobook and it was so damn good. So, you know, I want to read it again. And then another book that I really enjoy, I want to say The Henna Wars by Adiba J. Girda. That's also, wait, oh yeah, of course this book, yeah. But then also Darius the Great Is Not Okay by Adip Karam, another fantastic book that I really, really recommend. And then of course The Sequel, oh my goodness, Darius the Great Deserves Better. Oh my goodness, these books are amazing. So it was actually really hard to coordinate these books right here just because I want them to stick together, because you know, these three books are written by the same author and then this is a series, as you can see. So I didn't really want to separate them, so I'm just gonna have them here. So yeah, this is what they look like. And now the fourth bookshelf. This one basically has books that are written by Asian authors, or like it has like main characters who are Asian. So real quick, I know that like, for example, I'll Be the One, and then like The Henna Wars, Honey and Issue, Darius the Great, those books are written by Asian authors as well. And then of course the main characters are Asian. However, they also deal with LGBTQIAP+. So I put them on the very first shelf, you know, or third shelf, you get it. But I feel like those books can be on this shelf right here, but I chose them to be up here. But of course, in the future, if this shelf is getting too full, then I might have to make some arrangement. You get it. But real quick, the reason why I have one shelf for LGBTQIAP+ and then one shelf for like Asian books, you know, is because I am Asian. I am from Vietnam. I'm Vietnamese. I love being Vietnamese. I'm very proud of who I am and where I'm from. And then also, I am I'm a part of the LGBTQIAP+ community. So those two things are very, very important to me. They are part of my identity. So of course I want to have like two different shelves for like the books that I read, or like the books that can fit in those categories. I hope that makes sense. But just so you know, I love reading books and I do read like as much as I can with like different topics and different things, you know. But yeah, I don't want people to like take offense, I don't know. But real quick, yeah, that's my explanation. So the fourth shelf, I tried to color coordinate everything, of course, you know, from like white to pink, kinda. Well, it's not really pink, it's mostly white, and then yellow, and then pink, and then blue, and then purple. So the book that I have showing, you know, showing out. This is The Way You Make Me Feel by Maureen Gu, and it's actually one of my favorite books ever. I read this in 2020 and I really loved it, like way more than I thought, you know. So I have it out and about right here. And then another book that I would recommend is Parachutes by Kelly Yang, because this book is about our two main characters who are Asian, well, not Asian American, but Asian. But then also it deals with rape culture and it's a very heavy book. So, you know, read it with caution. It's pretty long, but I listened to the audiobook. It was so good. So of course afterward I got a physical copy for myself and I'm very happy about that. And then of course A Fall Love Story, oh my god, look, a book about, you know, two Vietnamese main characters, and then also the author is Vietnamese. It's actually wonderful. So another book that I would recommend, there is a book that I definitely want to read, and that is Counting Down With You. I got this copy when it came out and I still have not read this book, which is such a shame. However, since I'm in the mood to read like a bunch of romance novels, I really hope that I can read this next. So that's basically it for like this shelf. Is full of books by Asian authors and then of course with Asian main characters as well. So it's been great. Don't mind me. And now this shelf, I'm just gonna be behind the camera because it's just easier and, you know, we're getting lower. So over here I have the books that have like the red spine and, you know, black and white. So again, I was trying to color coordinate everything. So we have like red and then pinks here and then orange and then green and then blue. So this shelf is actually full. So this is like my YA contemporary shelf. I will say, I don't know if you can tell, but this bookcase right here, or not bookcase, but this shelf is like bending down a little bit just because all of the books here are like mostly hardcover books, you know. So I'm worried for this shelf, but I think it should be fine. And now the very last shelf, this is full of my journal. journals because I also journal. So these are all my finished bullet journals. So as you can see, they're mostly from Archer and Olive. And these two right here, the reason why they're so big is because those are my life journals. And you know, I do a lot of things in that journal. So yeah, they're pretty big. And then here I have my game. And then this is a journal for my boyfriend, this Hamilton book that I got like years ago. And then my friend's like poetry book, I believe. So everything on this shelf is just like miscellaneous stuff, but I try to make it organized. And now the next shelf, this is like my fantasy shelf because it mostly has fantasy books, but also it has like science fiction. Oh my god, I was gonna say design dystopian, but it has science fiction, dystopian books, and then also other books as well. So the very first shelf, we have, you know, that series. Okay, cool, let's move on. So this is my science fiction and dystopian books. So I have like Jade City, Renegades. I have Warcross and Wildcard right here. Let me show you what they look like. So these are the arcs that I got from Sandy. I have the finished copy of Warcross by Marie Lu right here. So yeah, this is like, I guess, my Marie Lu section, because I do have a few of her books. So I have like the Legend series, and oh my god, I have a vicious wow, forgot about that. But yeah, I have the Legend series here, and then of course the Hunger Games series, and then Scythe, the Arc of Scythe series by Neil Schusterman. That was, you know, a fun time. And then of course I have the Handmaid's Tale, and real quick, I have Stardust by Neil Gaiman. I put it here just, is this science fiction? I don't know. Oh my god, I actually don't know. But I'm just gonna put it here because it's been sitting here for a while. Oh my god, I hope the lighting is decent. I think I look too bright. But anyway, this shelf right here, basically this is like my paranormal kind of shelf, okay? But basically we're dealing with like aliens, angels, vampires, fairies over here. Yeah, those are mostly the creatures that we're dealing with. So I have the Lux series. Do you guys remember the Lux series by Jennifer L. Armentrout? These books were so popular when I was like a junior in high school. Like, oh my goodness, I remember the hype for these books. And I feel like now if I were to reread those books, I would literally drag all of them. However, when I was young, it was, you know, a fun time. So I mostly keep them for the sentimental value. And also I have them signed by the author, so it's really nice to have them. And then here I have the Angel Fall. Oh my god, it's stuck. So I have the Angel Fall trilogy by Susan E. I feel like these books were pretty underrated. Here I have Laura and Lust. Oh my god, I want to show you the cover because it's so pretty. So this is by Carla Nicole. Oh my goodness, I cannot wait to read this book because I think this is a romance book, you know, that deals with vampires. Cannot wait to read this. And then of course I have the vampire books by Rochelle Mee. So here we have Vampire Academy and then the Bloodlines trilogy. And then I have this Polaroid of Rose and Dimitri. I don't know why, I don't care for this couple literally at all. I have The Darkest Part of the Forest by Holly Black, and then the Cruel Prince trilogy, the Wicked of the Air trilogy by Holly Black. So those books are over here. And then up here I have an arc of The Lost Girls by Sonia Harto. But yeah, this is what it looks like. I really love the cover, so hopefully I can read this soon. Yet again, I am on my knees. I don't remember how I filmed this video last time, but here we are. These two shelves right here, this is my fantasy shelf and also like thriller shelf. I have like three books in that genre, but most of these books are fantasy. So I like to organize everything by like the type of book, so like paperback and then hardcover, and then also by height because it makes sense in my mind. So over here we have most of like the paperback books that I have, and then I have this thing right here because it came with like the PR box. Is that the right term? But basically it came with Kingdom of Souls, yeah, by Raina Baron. And this is a crime, I still have not read this book, and I've had this for 2 years, so I really want to read it, but I don't know when because I'm not in the mood to read fantasy books right now, which is really weird. But anyway, I have these things right here. And then of course I have some books from Fairyloot because I'm working with them and they send me boxes. And look at this book right here, Define the Night by Bridget Cameron. Oh my god, look at the pages. It's purple, which, you know, I love. Oh my god, it's so pretty. And then here I have Wicked Fox, Vicious Spirits, and then Cemetery Boys by Aidan Thomas, which is a really, really great book. Wait, is this fantasy? Here I have The Rise of Kiyoshi and then The Shadow of Kiyoshi. Look at this beautiful cover. I cannot wait to read the sequel. And here I have Girls of Paper and Fire, and then Girls of Storm and Shadow, and then the third book is coming out very soon. And then here I have An Ember in the Ashes series, the Poppy War series. I have the first two books right here. This is the cover for the second book, and it's so pretty. Oh my god, I love it so much. And then here I have A Curse So Dark and Lonely by Bridget Cameron, and then I have Sorcery of Thorns by Margaret Rogerson. Can you see it? Because I was like obsessed with this book when I first read it. You know, it was a fun time. And then of course, These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong. So very excited for the second book because it's coming out, I think next month or like this month when you're watching this video. And of course, I pre-ordered the second book. Very excited for that. And now the fourth shelf. These are some amazing books that I got from Fairy Loot because again, the Fairy Loot edition, they're always so pretty. So this is Fire with Fire, and as you can see, oh my god, it's gorgeous. And then this one, oh my god, this is the first book that I got from Fairy Loot, and I was like obsessed with how this looks. So this is The Prison Healer by Lynette Noni, and look at this. Do you see this? This is absolutely gorgeous. Oh my god. So I cannot wait to get the second book because I did order the Fairy Loot edition of the second book, and I still have not read this book. Oh my god, I need to, because this edition is so pretty. I cannot get over it. I have Legendborn and then The Starlet Sea. Oh my god, look at this edition. Wow, I have some really great editions. Kind of happy about that. So this is what I have right here. And then I have Children of Blood and Bone, Children of Virtue and Vengeance, and then this is my Leigh Bardugo shelf section. So I do have a few books from the author, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm not really interested in reading her books anymore. I feel like they're just not my cup of tea anymore, like, which is really weird because I feel like when I was young, I was like obsessed with Leigh Bardugo and her books. But these are the ones that I have in my collection still. So the Grisha trilogy, and then the Six of Crows duology, and then the Language of Thorns. So that's basically it. Last but not least, I have these three books right here. So Sadie, The Taking of Jake Livingston, and then Ace of Spades. Oh my god, look at this cover. It's so pretty. I cannot wait to read this book soon because I've heard like amazing things about this book, and I mean it, like amazing things about this book in particular. So I definitely want to read it. And then I have Vulpix right here. So this is a plushie that my boyfriend gave me 2 years ago. So this is the Alolan version of Vulpix, and he lives right over here because he fits. Kind of. These last two shelves right here, as you can see, they don't deal with fantasy books, but I have, you know, space. So of course I decided to put all these books here. So I want to say from here to here, this is my nonfiction part of my bookshelf. So this one, I got this yesterday. So this is White Tears, Brown Scars, How White Feminism Betrays Women of Color. This is a really great nonfiction book that I read earlier this year. So I'm glad that I have a final copy. So everything else is memoirs because I really enjoy reading memoirs. So, you know, I have I Am Malala, and then Dear Girls by Ali Wong, Oh Boys Aren't Blue by George M. Johnson. This is actually an ARC that Sandy gave me, so thank you so much to Sandy. I got this a few months ago, so this is Crying in H Mart by Michelle Zauner. I really want to read this book because I've heard amazing things. And then of course, The Glass Castle, Know My Name, The Unwanted, and then Becoming. So these are some really great memoirs that I really, you know, recommend. So that's basically the first part. And now the rest, I don't know. I feel like these books just make sense in my mind, you know, how they look. But I guess genre-wise, I don't know. This is like, I guess, literary fiction, I think. Kinda, I don't know. But basically, I have Such a Fun Age by Kelly Reid. I read this last year. I really enjoy it. So I have, you know, the final copy. The Vanishing Half by Britt Bannon. This is also an amazing book that I got, I think, on Mother's Day because it was 50% off. So I'm really glad about that because I really enjoyed this book as well. And then here I have two books from Celeste Ng, Everything I Never Told You and then Little Fires Everywhere. And then here, this is, I guess, my Taylor Jenkins Reid section. So I have four books from that author after I do. The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, which is literally one of my favorite books of all time. Like, I love this so much. And then Daisy Jones and the Six, and then Malibu Rising. I really need to read this one. And then here I have A Little Life. I'm very, very scared to read that book because I've heard that it's sad. That's the thing. And I'm so scared to read that book. And then this one, I got this from Fairy Loot. I don't even know who this guy is, but he's chilling right there. And now the very last shelf of this huge bookshelf right here. So over here I have like my poetry section. So I used to read a lot of poetry books, but not anymore. So I have like a few copies, but that's about it. So this is what I have in my collection. And then I have like a few classics, as you can see. So I really love this edition right here. This is the Penguin English Library edition. So this is Passing by Nell Larson. So yeah, I really want to collect classics in that edition. And then the rest is historical fiction. So this makes sense in my mind because I do, surprisingly, I have quite a few books from that genre, so I put everything here. So a lot of these books I read for school, but there are a few books that I read for fun in the past, like The Book Thief. I read for fun. This was not a fun time, okay? I read this a long time ago and I remember crying so much because this book broke me, you know? But yeah, I read that book. I also read I Am the Messenger by Marcus Zusak. And then yeah, I really want to read The Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. I've heard amazing things about this book and I've had this copy for a few years and I still have not read this book, which is such a crime. So I really, really hope I can read that book soon. And then here I have Espeon because she is my favorite Eevee evolution, and I got this plushie from my friend Ray, which is really nice. So thank you so much, Ray. And now this last shelf, kind of, but basically this is like, I don't know how to call this. I think it's like my fandom shelf kind of way. I don't know. But basically I have like three shelves for Cassandra Clare because I have so many of her books. And then the very last shelf is like my Rick Riordan shelf. So let's start with this one right here because this is my Infernal Devices shelf because I have so many copies of this trilogy. Like, I'm not kidding. Here, this is the Vietnamese edition. Surprisingly, I got a hold of that, so you know, that was really nice. This is the, is it manga or mangua? I don't know. But here I have, you know, that edition. And then here, this is the paperback edition with the cool spines. Oh my god, and here's Snorlax. He looks so cute. So that's three editions already. This is the next edition, okay? This is just the regular hardcover US edition. And then here I have the Illumicrate special edition that my boyfriend got me for our anniversary, which is really crazy. So real quick, I want to show you what they look like. Oh my god, look at that. It's gorgeous. This is so beautiful. But yeah, they're very, very small and tiny. So I have them over here. And then of course, last but not least, I have a Clockwork Angel. This is the 10th anniversary edition, as you can see. So I'm like, yeah, I'm obsessed with this trilogy. As you can see, it's my favorite series of all time. And then here I have a Polaroid of Will and Tessa. And then of course I have the Clockwork Angel. Oh my goodness, look at that. And then here I have these standees from Illumicrate as well. So I have like Will, Gem, and Tessa. And yeah, that's basically my TID shelf. I have 5 editions of one trilogy. Again, I hope the lighting is okay. I don't even know what's going on anymore. Real quick, this is the tarot cards that I got, I think 2 years ago, which is really surprising because like time has gone by so fast. 2.5 years ago, I think. So I got this at Book Expo and BookCon of 2019, which happened in May/June of 2019. And then here I have the Mortal Cup that I got from Fairy Loot because they did this thing for Chain of Gold. Over here I have like the graphic novels for the More Instruments. So as you can see, this is what they look like. So this is volume 4 right here. And now my beloved copy of City of Ashes. If you don't know, this book and this copy is very, very special because this is the book that got me into reading back in 2013. And I really mean it. Like, because of this book, I read a lot now. I read for fun, you know? So I got this signed by Cassandra Clare, as you can you see? But she signed it right here, and then I have Emma's signature right here. So shout out to Sandy, because of her, I got this book signed by Cassandra Clare, which is really, really cool. And here I have the More Instruments series. So I have City Bones, Ashes, Glass, Fallen Angels, Lost Souls, and then Heavenly Fire. That is my dog. All of these books are hardcover, as you can see. And then over here I have the Bane Chronicles, Tales from the Shadowhunter Academy, and then Ghosts of the Shadow Market. And then I have the Shadowhunter Codex, and then City of Bones, the 10th anniversary edition. And then I have this book right here. I have a lot of books from Cassandra Clare. Like, I've always known that, but now that I'm doing a bookshelf tour and I'm just like going over everything that I have, I'm just like really surprising myself at how many books I have for the Shadowhunter Chronicles. But hey, I'm in love with this world, and also I'm into deep. And this shelf, this is my very last like Shadowhunter shelf. So over here I have the Dark Artifices, and then like, what you call it, the Rescuers of Magic kind of trilogy, and then I also have The Last Hours. Wow, I have three different series. So real quick, I have these pins right here from TVA. So because of Sandy, you know, I got this, and then Sandy also gave this to me for Christmas a few years ago, which is really crazy. And then over here, oh my god, I literally just cleaned this shelf last week. How is it already dusty? What is going on? But anyway, over here I have the Dark Artifices trilogy. So these two books right here, this is like the Vietnamese edition of Lady Midnight and then Lord of Shadows. And then here, this is the US copy of the books, and this is literally my favorite cover from the Shadowhunter Chronicles. Okay, I love this shade of blue, and I love the dress. I think Annabelle looks evil, but she looks pretty, you know. I don't like her, but still, this is a stunning cover. And then I have the Waterstones edition of Lord of Shadows, and then Queen of Air and Darkness. I don't have one for Lady Midnight because it's so rare. Like, will I ever get it? I don't know, but hopefully I will in the future, but we'll see. This pin is of Malik, as you can see. So this is from the book, the last book of the last book of the white. And then yeah, I have the Rescuers of Magic, the last book of the white, and then I have the Waterstones edition, as you can see. And then here, oh, my Last Hours section. Oh my god, look at these cards of the characters. I'm obsessed with them. And then also, oh my god, this book right here. This is everything to me, because earlier this year I received an arc of Chain of Iron, which is the second book of the Last Hours trilogy, and of course the author is Cassandra Clare. This is my very first Cassandra Clare arc, and it's such a big deal. So I have it right here, as you can see, because, you know, I don't have a shelf for my arcs anymore, so I just put it here. And then of course I have Chain of Gold, Chain of Iron. These are the finished copies. And over here I have the Waterstones edition. So this is Chain of Gold, and then this is Chain of Iron. And I really love like the colors, so I'm glad I'm collecting the Waterstones edition. And then here I got this with the arc. So this is a DIY embroidery kit that I never use. And then also this is the map of like the places in Chain of Iron, I think. I don't know. Yeah. Yeah, Chain of Iron. Wow, I was correct. So that's basically it for the very last Shadowhunter shelf. And now the very last shelf, as you can see, this is, you know, dedicated to Rick Riordan, because he writes like so many series. So over here I have like the these books, you know, like the companion books that deals with Percy Jackson. So I have all three of them. And then of course here I have Percy Jackson and the Olympians. I have the hardcover, which is really, really nice because I prefer having the hardcover. And then here I have Heroes of Olympus. Oh my god, the Heroes of Olympus series, and then the Trials of Apollo series, and then the Magnus Chase series. So I have not read the Magnus Chase books, but you know, I really want to read them sometime in the future. And then here I have a Polaroid of Nico and Reyna. That's basically it for this shelf. And now let's go to the very last bookshelf. Okay, so this is basically the very last bookshelf in my room. Basically, this is my manga slash comic book slash graphic novel shelf. So I do have quite a actually, I have a lot. Let's face it, I definitely have a lot. And you know, I do like the way everything is organized. The very top of the bookshelf, basically I have the Your Name DVD that was gifted to me by my boyfriend, because you know, he knows that I love that movie. And I have a picture of my dad, some nail polishes, because yeah, one rack isn't enough. I need two racks, okay? So these are the leftover nail polishes. And then I have like two, what you call it, magazine holders basically. So they have like magazines and all that fun stuff. So now let's get to the actual bookshelf. The very first row, I have tons of manga. So over here I have like the Orange Trilogy. It's not really a trilogy, what am I saying? But I have the Orange manga right here. So this is like Orange, the Complete Collection, Volume 1. Oh, oops, wrong one. Volume 1, I have 2, and then Orange Future. So I definitely need to read Orange 2, because I don't know why. I've had this for almost a year, but I never read it. So that's really, really weird. But I definitely need to read this and then read Orange Future as well. Right here I have the Your Name manga. So I have Volume 1, 2, and 3. So I got these manga, I think, after I watched the movie. And to be honest, you just need to watch the movie, okay? The movie is already phenomenal. You really don't need to read the manga. Sure, there are some extra scenes, but at the same time, it doesn't change the story altogether. So just watch the movie and you'll be fine. Of course, I have Watakoi, Love is Hard for Otaku. So I have 4 volumes. So this is actually, no, there's actually a fifth one, surprisingly. So I really need to read the fourth volume so I can continue with this series. But I will say this is not like my favorite manga series ever. I do enjoy the show very much, so that's why I really want to read the manga, because there's no news of season 2. So that kind of scares me, because season 1 is really, really good. So I really hope they will have another season, you know, because I do believe the show is kind of better than the manga. But that's just my opinion. Over here, I have Fullmetal Alchemist. So I have all 27 volumes. However, these are the ones that are like 3-in-1, you know, so it's like a nice bind up. And in a way, you save a lot of money because there are 3 volumes in one, and it's like roughly $15. So if you think about it, each volume is like $5, which is a pretty great deal. So I have all of it, and then I also have Silver Spoon Volume 1 because it's also written by the same author. But I don't have the rest of the series just because I never really wanted to collect this series. So I just have the very first volume because my boyfriend gave this to me for my birthday. And now this is the second row. So here I have all of my horror manga. So let's start with the very first cube. So here I have all of the volumes in Tokyo Ghoul. So I'm not collecting the Tokyo Ghoul Re, something like that. It's like another series, you know. This is just the very first series, and I have all 14 volumes because I really like loved the series last year. It was so much fun. So I have all 14 volumes. And then over here I have all of the books by Junji Ito. So as of right now, I'm reading No Longer Human, so that's why there's a bookmark right here. So my favorite is Uzumaki. It looks like this. It's literally so, so good because it's like about Spiral. And out of all of the books that I have read from him so far, Uzumaki is the one that really have like a long-lasting impression on me, because to this day, it's been a year, this book scared me the most because it was truly terrifying, okay? Like really, really scary stuff. As you can see here, this is the very third row. So over here I have all of the Beastars volume. I think as of right now I have everything. I think I really, really enjoyed the series. I have read 12 volumes so far, so I definitely need to catch up because I need to read 13, 14. And then here, this is Beast Complex volume 1, so this is a little bit different, but still I have not read this yet. So yeah, I just need to like catch up on this series because I'm kind of falling behind, surprisingly, because I feel like a year ago I was like really good with like keeping up with each volume. But as of right now, my favorite volume, no wait, my favorite book covers, there we go, this one, I love this cover of Legoshi very much, mostly because of this shade of blue. I'm biased. But then also volume 8, I love Legoshi and Haru on this. Look at this, oh my goodness, I love you know, the book cover. So that's basically what I have to say about Beastars. And then over here I have my Avatar The Last Airbender comic section. So I think I have all of the comic books, and it was definitely a pain to collect everything, but as of right now I'm pretty much caught up, so I'm very happy about that. So here we have like the trilogy, because there are like I think 5 trilogies for Avatar The Last Airbender. And then we have The Legend of Korra, so like Turf Wars, and then Ruins of the Empire. That was also a good time. And then these 3 books right here are like fairly recent, so let me get them out. So as you can see, this is like, I don't know, I view this as like a trilogy, because here we have Katara, and then Toph, and then Suki, which is like really, really cool. I also have the DVDs over here, and then I have a bunch of pins for Avatar The Last Airbender. So here's Aang, and then Toph right here. So yeah, this is basically my Avatar The Last Airbender section. Alright folks, the very last row. But real quick, I do want to show you this book right here. So this is The Complete Art of Fullmetal Alchemist, and my boyfriend got this to me. What? My boyfriend gave this to me 2 years ago, and yeah, it's really, really nice. However, it's huge. It's freakishly big, so it does not even fit one shelf. So I just have to put it on the side of the bookshelf, which is unfortunate because the collecting does. But anyway, let's get back to the very last shelf. Wait, no, the last row, basically. So over here, I have, I guess, like my graphic novels, and then yeah, this is comic book. Oh my god, I'm getting things mixed up. Then over here, this is my other graphic novels. So over here I have the Babysitter's Club. I have 9 volumes right now, but I will say I'm gonna stop collecting these books just because I have outgrown them. I don't know why, for a while I keep collecting them because obviously it was fun to get the books when I was an adult, because you know, these things are like really cute and childish, obviously, because these books are about children. However, in 2021 I'm kind of over it, so I'm going to stop collecting the volumes, you know. I'm just gonna stop collecting these books. And then here I have Heartstopper volume 1, 2, and 3 and 4, obviously. So this is the newest one right here. I have not read this yet, which is ridiculous. So I really, really need to read this. Of course, we also have to talk about Friends because these books are amazing. I have all four volumes and I love them so much. And now the very last cube. So like I said, these are my graphic novels. So I have Fangs over here because I actually really enjoyed this book. This was a fun time. So I really like that. And then I have like Genderqueer, Stargazing. I have an arc of it and then also the final copy. So as you can see, they are kind of, actually they're completely different obviously. So in here is actually just like black and white. In the newer version, in the final version, as you can see, everything is colored in. So that's really nice. I also love The Princess and the Dressmaker. No, sorry, The Prince and the Dressmaker by Jen Wang, I believe. And then one of my favorites is All American Girl by Robin Ha. I love this book so much just because I feel really represented when I read this, you know. So it was a really, really good time. So yeah, I have the final copy. And again, my boyfriend bought this for me for graduation, I think a year ago. So shout out to Jonathan. So that's basically it for this bookshelf. Everything is organized and I do love the way everything looks.
I've been filming for so long. I've been here for like at least an hour and it's like almost midnight right now, which is not a good thing, but I'm finally done. I'm very happy about that. And also I'm very, very happy that I finally got a chance to do this video because I've been thinking about it for so long. And of course, I'm glad that I finally do it now because I'm actually very happy with how all of my shelves are organized. That's basically it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoy it. A reminder that Ana Luisa is having a sale right now. So you can click my link down in the description box below to check out the jewelry pieces that they have because, oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this necklace matching with this earring and then this ring right here. I'm in love with their jewelry pieces and of course I cannot wait to get a few of my own for like, you know, myself and then also for my family members, you know, for Christmas because I really want to spoil them with some good quality jewelry pieces. So that's basically it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe for more videos and I will see you guys later. Goodbye!
You mean bread and butterflies?
Oh yes, of course.